Hi everyone! Welcome back to IntegralCalc.com. Today we're going to be taking the derivative of the function f of x equals 1 divided by the natural log of x. And we're going to need the quotient rule formula here that I've written because our function is a fraction. 1 is the numerator, natural log or ln of x is the denominator, and the quotient rule formula tells us how to take the derivative of something when we're dealing with a fraction. So the derivative of f of x is always written as f prime of x. And what our formula tells us is that, see, we've got f of x as our numerator and g of x as our denominator. So our formula tells us that the first thing that we need is the derivative of our numerator. The derivative of our numerator is 0 because our numerator is 1, which is a constant, and the derivative of any constant is 0. So for f prime of x, we've got 0. Then we need g of x, which is the denominator, exactly as it is without doing anything to it. So we're going to be multiplying this times the natural log, or ln of x, our denominator. Then we subtract, and we write in f of x, which is our numerator, is exactly as it is, which is 1. And then we multiply that by the derivative of our denominator. Now the derivative of the natural log of x, we've written here as a formula. And this is just a formula from calculus that you should definitely know and memorize. The derivative of natural log of x is 1 over x. So we'll go ahead and write that in for g prime of x. And then we're going to be dividing this whole thing by g of x squared, in other words, by our denominator squared. So we go ahead and write ln of x, and we're going to be squaring the whole thing because we grabbed our denominator, put it in here, and we're squaring it. So that's essentially our derivative function, and now in order to get our final answer, all we need to do is simplify as much as we can. So you'll notice that the first term in our numerator is going to go away because we have 0 multiplied by natural log of x, so that whole term is going to become 0. And then for the second term, we're going to end up with, this one is redundant, we don't really need to write it, so we'll end up with negative 1 over x. So negative 1 over x, and then our denominator is still just going to be the natural log of x squared. Now, in order to convert this into something simpler, the thing that I find easiest to do is a little bit of algebra with this fraction right here. Sorry, this is a negative right here. If for example, you've got a fraction like this, maybe you've got, let's say, 2/5, and you're dividing that by 8, right? We've got a fraction in our numerator and then just something in our denominator like this, 2/5 divided by 8. Instead of 2/5 divided by 8, you can convert this to 2/5 times 1 over 8. So instead of dividing, we're multiplying, and what allows us to do that is that we flip this 8 upside down and make it 1 over 8. So no matter what you've got in your denominator here, you can put 1 over your denominator and multiply instead of divide. So in our case, we can do negative 1 over x, and then instead of dividing by ln of x squared, we will multiply it by 1 over ln of x squared. And this allows us to see how we're going to simplify this a lot easier. So notice that we're going to end up with negative 1 in the denominator because we've just got 1 times 1 with this negative sign out here. And then in the denominator, we'll end up with x times the natural log of x squared. And that's it. That's about as much as we can simplify. So we'll go ahead and call that our final answer. And our final answer, of course, is going to be in the form f prime of x, which indicates that this is the derivative of the function f of x. So f prime of x is equal to negative 1 divided by x times the natural log, or ln, of x squared. That's it. That's our final answer. I hope this video helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!